Hey guys, welcome to another Elementor tutorial. Today we'll be covering the image widgets, and we're starting right now. So when editing your page, this is what we see. However, I want to get rid of my site title and my page title. How can you do that? Pretty easy. Well, I'll just go to settings down there and choose your page layout to be an Elementor canvas. Click over it. All right, drag and drop the image widget over here, and then we can edit our image. This is just a filler image to show you how it looks. The first thing we do, of course, is change our image. So we press on choose image, and then you can upload an image or just choose one in your library that you already have. Let's go with the elephant and press insert media. There are a few options within the widgets. We're going to cover them all. The first thing you can change is the image size. Do you want it to be large, or do you want it to be full, which is in our case this size, or do you want to have it smaller or a custom? And if you want to keep the ratio, just type in, for example, 500 width and press apply, then it will calculate by itself. But if I change the height to, for example, 2000, I will get a completely other image. So you can use any image size you want. We're going to use full image size for this tutorial. Click on this one. The alignment. The alignment is where do you want to align this image within your container. It doesn't do anything right now because it is set to full. But if I go with a thumbnail, for example, now you can change the place where the image will be within the container. Let's get back to full. Now the caption is the text that you gave up in your media library. So if I now press this button, nothing will happen. Why? I'm going to show you. Click on your image itself. Select your image you're using. And now you can see on the right side you have a caption over there. You don't want to have an elephant sit on your car. And now I press somewhere else. Now it is saved, as you can see. Now we can close this one. And now when I change the caption back to attachment caption, you will see that the text is over here. But you can also choose a custom caption, which will enable you to type it in yourself. You also don't want to have an elephant sit on your 4K monitor. So that is the caption you can give with your image. Most of the time I don't use captions, but when you use it is, for example, in a blog, so that you can actually tell about the image you're seeing on screen. Again, you can get a custom caption dynamically filled, but you need Elementor Pro. Then we can have a link. You can actually link to the media file. Why is that useful? Well, then you can use a lightbox. So let's say I have a small thumbnail of my elephant. And if I put the link to my media file, this is what happens when you click on your file. It opens in a lightbox, which can be very useful in your case. But you also can link to a custom URL. For example, my own website, and then you can press on link options, and here you can open a new window. I always encourage a new window when you are leaving your own website. If you are just navigating within your own website, just uncheck this box. Add a nofollow. Well, this is for SEO purposes. If you don't want to leak some SEO value to another website, then you can add nofollow. This is very important, for example, on your homepage. And here you can add some custom attributes for accessibility and SEO and that kind of stuff. But the link now opens in a new window. So when I preview my changes, when I press this, I just go to my website. Oh, this is still the coming soon website. I have a new website on the backend, but I still need to finalize it. So maybe it's already completed when you're watching this video. Who knows? Let's get rid of the URL and let's put it back to full. Those are the image options. Let's go to style. Within the style options, you can choose percentage, pixels, or view width. Change the width of your image. This is pretty cool. Now keep in mind that with every website you're building, you have to check it on your mobile view right there. The beautiful thing of Elementor is that you can also change the size for different devices. Most page builders have this, but it's very useful that you can do it per option. So let's change 50% on mobile. And for example, on my tablet, I want it to be 80%. and on my desktop, I want it to be 100%. That's so possible. If I now switch to my mobile view, over here you can go to responsive mode, right there, and you can change it. Now you can see that the width is 50%, the width is 80%, and back to 100%. Keep that in mind, it's very useful to use this little thing. Now the max width is very useful if we are going to add a maximum width, for example, different sizes of screens. So let's go to pixels, and then I want my max width to be 800 pixels. Now you can use this. Let's say our width is 100%, then it will only stay within this 800 pixels I have created over there. And if I now change it, this will happen. But let's say my max width is 500, then my percentage will always stay within this 500. This way you can actually control the way people see your website on different sizes of monitors, on different devices. It is pretty useful. We're going to use it when building our website with Elementor. And the height is actually the same. You can use it to change the height of your image. Now then we have object fit. So let me show you when it is useful. We're going to delete the height. I need this container to be full width on my screen. So we go to this option, edit container. Content width will be full width right there. Now we have a beautiful full screen. Now what if I want to have content below it? So I want this to be a little bit smaller. We go back to our image. And then we're going to change the height to, let's say, 400 pixels. This doesn't look very good. So here comes the object fit in place. We're going to change this to cover right there. Now you have the beautiful elephant on the right place. And now we can just change the height to what we want to show. So let's put it on 700, for example. Now we have a beautiful elephant, full wide, but not the full picture because it's higher and lower normally. All right, then we have the opacity. With the opacity, you can actually change, of course, the opacity. When is this useful? When you want to show also the background right through the image. Let me show you how that works. We just go to the container, edit it, and we're going to change the style, and then we go to background type, classic, because I want to have a image as a background. We're going to use the forest as our background. Click on it, insert media. As you can see right here a little bit now, you can see that there's a background. All right, we go back to our image. We go to content. Let's change this image for this guy. Insert media. Now we have a guy. All right. And if I go back to our opacity option, now we can use this effect to change the opacity of this guy. And then we have CSS filters. Click on it. And here you can go all nuts. You can blur images. You can change the brightness of this image. You can change the contrast of your image. You can change saturation to remove all the colors, make it black and white, for example. And of course, the hue. If you want to reset all these settings, which I can, of course, imagine, then you just press on this one back to default right there. There you are. Next option is the border type. You can add a border to your image. Although this is a PNG file, which is transparent, it gives the border to the image itself. All right, let's use a dotted border. You can change the width of your border. How does it work? Well, if I just type 5 right there, let me show you, it just gets bigger, right? You can change this per side. So if you press unlink these values, you can make the top bigger than the bottom, like this. Also with solid, you can actually change this. If you want to link them together, press this button and now everything is the same again. All right, here you can change the color of your borders like this. I already explained the global colors in my other tutorial. And there is the border radius, which you can use to create beautiful rounded edges on your image. Now, actually, I really don't like the border style, so I'm gonna delete them all and delete the radius. But I do like the box shadows. I'm a big fan of shadow using in website because it actually looks pretty amazing with most images, not with all of them. You can blur it, of course. You can change the horizontal and vertical position of your shadow, just like this. You can change the blur. You can change the spread of this thing. So it's pretty obvious, but that is the box shadow. If you don't want it, just press this back to default, like this. Then the last option of styling is the caption. Within the caption options, you can change everything there is about the caption. You can change the color to whatever you want. You can change the alignment. The alignment is within the container, not the image itself. So here you go, put it on the right side, put it in the center. And you can change the color, the background color. So you can actually make it stand out like this. And you can also change the typography, of course, change it to another font. And you can make it bigger, like that. You can change everything about the fonts, just the way we're used to within Elementor. The spacing, the line height, word spacing, and then it totally looks ridiculous, but it's all possible. Reset to default, of course. And the spacing is pretty useful if you want to have more space so it's not connected to your image. If you now go over to advanced, I've talked about all these things in the first tutorial about the header widget. So we're not gonna talk about all these things, but there is one I told you we'll be using with the image widget, and that is the mask. So click on the mask. And if you now enable the mask, you can do some real cool stuff with the image. So for example, you have different kind of mask you can apply, something like flowers, sketch. Let us use another image to make it more clear what I'm talking about. We go to content, change the image over here. Let's go with the elephant and press insert media. Now we go back to advanced, we go back to mask, and now we can change the masks to a circle. This is what's happening. You can go with a flower, beautiful, sketch, which actually looks really great. And you can go with a triangle, you can go with a blob, hexagon, or just create a custom. And here you can upload your own SVG, so you can create any kind of layer you want using, for example, Photoshop or Canva, and you can upload it and then you can see it on your website. So if we now go with a flower, there are a few other things you can change. We can change the size to make it fill it out in the entire container, or we can use custom, just like the width and the height, you can change it to whatever you want. Let's use fit. And you can change the position of your mask to center, or on the left side, or on the right side, or maybe you want to have it on the bottom. You can see it actually right now because of the size of the image. If we make it bigger, you can see what it does on the bottom or the top, or again, custom. And here you can just change it completely the way you want to it to be. And that is really awesome. Now, if you go down here, you can repeat it. Of course, repeat it an endlessly horizontal, both vertically, X and IS, or you can repeat it around or in space. Now, you can see this when I put it back on custom. I'm gonna make it really small, like this. And then you can actually see what happens when we are going to repeat it like this, or repeat it only in the XS, like this, or repeat it on the YS, like this. Or you can just put it round. And we have, of course, a space like this. And within space, you cannot change any of the positions. So the mask is a pretty awesome thing you can use to create beautiful effects within your website, just to shine through that something is coming up. All right, guys, I hope you learned something new about the image widget. If you did, hit that like button or just say thank you in the comments if it was useful for you. If you want to see more videos, hit that subscribe button or just click over here and go to the next widget. I'll see you in the next video. Have an awesome day.